Perfecto Yasay Jr., former chairman of the Securities and Exchange Commission, and he was among those who testified in the impeachment trial against former President Joseph Estrada, which led to Estrada's ouster. Good morning to you, sir.
Good morning, Karen. So, good morning to everybody watching us.
So what do I call you? Do I call you Jun?
Call me Jun. Yeah,
all right. Okay. Right. Now, 14 days to go before May 10. How do you think is Baon Pilipinas doing?
We're doing very well.
Okay.
Even way beyond our expectations. The exit polls from our overseas voting have already started to come in, and we're number one.
Actually, so, I heard exit polls from Hong Kong, right?
From Hong Kong, and even from Saudi Arabia, from Lebanon, Libya, even from Thailand and Singapore.
Is that right?
And Brother Eddie and the Bangon Filipinas team are really leading in this exit poll.
You know, so what do you attribute this to? There have been many. Stars in terms of candidates, and yet in the exit polls, you have Brother Eddie Villanueva and yourself, who's not as high profile as the other candidates, and you're leading.
Yes, because, you know, with these elections, I think one of the sectors that will be most affected will be the overseas workers. They're really making sure that they will take active part in the shaping and choosing of leaders for our country. Mm-hmm. And they know what the issues are, and they know who the candidates are. They study this very thoroughly. And I think that's the effect, you know, knowing who they think will best serve their interests.
Okay, but why do you think do the OFWs prefer Bangon Pilipinas over the others? I mean, for example, Manny Villar has an advocacy with OFWs.
Yes, because of the integrity and the credibility of the Bangon Pilipinas candidates. You know, when you have your promises based upon your service to God and the country, our overseas workers find that very, very powerful. And this is precisely what we have over the rest of the candidates. You know, we have competence, we have integrity, we have character, we have experience. But more importantly, we have love of God and country.
Now, why did you choose to run for vice president?
I did not choose to run for vice president, Karen. I was, in fact, selected. I was chosen.
Oh, okay.
I felt that this was more of a calling.
So, was there a nomination process?
Yes, which I did not even know.
Okay.
Yeah, I only knew it in the last minute.
Okay.
People had invited me to run for the senatorial slate, and if I wanted just my personal interest to govern, then I would have said yes, because they said this would be my best chance to win. But I said, no, I'm not going to enter politics. But then again, the call for me to serve came about, and that's why I'm running for the vice presidency.
But why did you accept it?
Well, because I find in Bangon Filipinas, particularly under Brother Eddie Villanueva's leadership, the best opportunity and the best chance for people to achieve real change for this nation.
Mm-mm.
Yeah. Again, as I've said.
But do you go to JIL?
I am not a member of JIL.
Okay.
In fact, Brother Eddie is the only candidate who's a member of JIL.
Is that right?
Yes. We have two Muslim candidates. We have three Catholics who are very devout. And I'm a Protestant, but not a member of the JIL. And we really feel that if you want change to happen, change must start in your heart. And we really feel on the basis of our faith that change can only really happen if you let God into your heart and you fear God. And because of that fear of God, you would love our people truly.
Okay, now, not a lot of people. Now, let me phrase this properly. Some people don't take Bangon Pilipinas as seriously, given the fact that you have a pastor running, Brother Eddie Villanueva running, and during the last elections, he was only able to garner 2 million votes. So people even doubt his power within JIL.
Ito nga yung pagbabago natin din kinukuha, no? This is also the change that we are really pushing for, the mindsets of our people. When people think that only the popular, only the moneyed, only the ones with the machinery will win. And this is precisely why we do not believe in surveys, because surveys do not say anything about the candidates. And this is part of the rotten system that we want to change.
Mm-hmm.
So we feel, and we're telling our people in our campaigns, listen to the issues. You really want change? This is what you want, and this is what you must do.
Mm-hmm.
Don't listen to the surveys. So this is part of the change that we are pushing for, Karen.
But you don't feel uneasy that you have Brother Eddie Villanueva, who is a pastor with a large church, and some people feel he's using this for political gain?
No, Brother Eddie has effectively, and Bangon Filipinas has effectively addressed that issue. The concern is the issue of the separation of church and state. Unfortunately, you know, the reason why we have dirty politics coming in is because the good people have shied away from it, again under the guise of saying that we must not have the so-called, or an erroneous interpretation of the separation of church and state. And I think Brother Eddie has addressed it. He will be president for the entire people, not the GIAL, and when he has resigned from his pastoral work precisely to go to another level of service to the people.
All right. Our Twitters are They have tweets for you. Alcide240 says, Mr. Yasay, if you become unfortunate first for this 2010, would you still run for the next elections and what position?
As I've said, I run. I've decided to run for this election because I was called. And if there is no calling for me in the next election, then I will not run.
Mm-mm.
But as I've said, I'm running because I know that we will win. Yeah.
You and believe you win?
We believe we win, and we believe that the people are ready for change. If they listen to what we're saying, we will win.
All right, okay. Alec Francis, we have some Facebook questions for you. Alec Francis Santos asks, what's your take on church and state separation?
The church and state separation is a doctrine that was established to protect the church from the undue interference of the state, and not vice versa. And so
you agree with the church interfering with the state?
No, I agree. I agree with the church playing an important role in making sure that the nation is governed under righteousness and godliness. We even have in the preamble of the Constitution very clearly we implore the aid of Almighty God.
So now,
as
Vice President, what would your stand be, for example, on artificial contraception?
Artificial contraception is a choice that must be made by the couples. I believe in the primacy of choice of the individual according to the teachings mm-hmm. of their religion, and the state should not interfere on that.
So you believe it should be made available?
I believe that once the couple makes a decision that is in accordance with their faith and their religious teachings, then government must be ready to support and enforce that decision.
What about Ang Ladlad being a partyless group?
You know, I am against any sectoral group to be represented in Congress as a representative group. We're supposed to serve the people. You know, we're supposed to serve the people, the marginalized people. When you come up with the special sectoral mm-hmm. groups, there will be no end to that. You know, you will be coming up with special interest groups that will be governing our politics. I'm against it on that basis.
So you don't believe in party-list groups?
I don't believe in party-list groups.
Oh, very interesting. So do you want party lists abolished?
Abolished, yes.
Okay.
Because every representative of the land, every senator in our representative democracy must understand that when they are elected, they serve the interests of all the people, regardless of their gender, regardless of their religious affiliation, regardless of their status in life.
All right, okay. Tash Alemania has this question. If elected, what problem or issue will you tackle first?
Well, I will tackle first with Brother Eddie the issue of corruption, because that has really been the cause why we have never gotten off from the shackles of our poverty.
Mm-mm.
That will be the first thing. And the second is to make sure that we create an environment so that we have investors coming in. This is my experience. This is my forte. With investors coming in, then you will be fueling our capital for our industries,
Mm-mm.
and they will have jobs for our people.
Mm-mm.
So we will also like to teach our people entrepreneurial skills and empower them economically. We would like to see land reform work. We would like to see and make sure that our agricultural workers, who will be the most affected in terms of the implementation of our commitments to GATT and globalization, will be addressed.
Mm-hmm.
Unless we achieve the objectives of fair trade, I think free trade becomes an oppressive tool for our people. In this respect.
Now, what maybe a lot of our young voters don't remember is you actually gained popularity being chairman of the Securities and Exchange Commission during the time of former President Erap Estrada, in which during the impeachment trial you spoke and actually talked about his supposedly unethical behavior in calling you directly. Can you refresh our memory?
Yes, not only in calling me directly, but giving me orders in violation of the law.
What did Erap do?
Erap first...
This is 1999.